Hello creators! Welcome back to our channel. In today's video we will show you how to create some cool effects you might have seen in TikTok edits, namely camera tracking, ghost, and beat flash effect. Let's dive right in. Camera tracking effect. This effect allows you to track the movement of an object and adds dynamic to the video, making it more immersive. First off, we'll start with adding your video and audio by drag and drop function. If you need to crop a video, expand the video frame so that the desired frame part fits within the scene. Once that's done, head over to the Properties window and set the Resize mode to Super Sampling Interpolation. This tool allows you to track objects in the frame and create a motion path for it. Choose where to save your movement map, then place the character in the Analyze frame and click on Analyze. If the analysis isn't accurate, don't worry, you can switch the analysis algorithm. Once it looks good, click on Apply Editing. Now, to cut out the video borders that extend beyond the boundaries of the scene, create a sprite for your video by right-clicking on it on the timeline and resize it to fit the scene. In the Sprites Properties window, make sure you set Uses Container to No and Show Effects to Yes. Double-click on the sprite, then the video inside it, and add the movement map you just created by going to Add Object, Movement. If you have multiple video clips or have split the video during editing, you'll need to repeat these steps for each clip. It's also important to invert the trajectory of the effect in the Properties window. If playback appears jerky, you need to smooth the path by selecting Convert to Curve option in the Properties window. Set Tracking Inaccuracy to 0.1 and choose Bezier Curve as a movement type. Well done! Finally, add a zoom effect with the level set from 100 to 130 to smooth the transition on the frame. Ghost effect. Now let's move on to ghost effect. Right-click on the video clip on the timeline, convert it to sprite, and add to it a zoom effect with the level set from 100 to 130 in the Properties window. Duplicate this sprite, click on it, and change its zoom effect levels in the Properties window from 100% to 400%. Adjust the Bezier curve for a smoother transition. Select Screen for its composition mode to the left of the timeline. If you have several objects on the layer with this duplicate, make sure this option is selected only for this sprite in this Properties window. Now we need to make it so that the object becomes transparent. To do this, apply the custom transparency effect in the Properties window, set the transparency option from 100 to 0 and adjust the acceleration in the key editor to avoid boring linear transitions and make your video more attractive. Good job! Now we need to create the flicker effect. To do this, add another custom transparency. Click on the three dots to the right of transparency parameter in the Properties window, go to Templates in the menu of the key editor, and select the Edit the Beat. Make sure the correct audio file is selected and create points. For more information about this template, click on the link in the upper right corner. The resulting transparency depends on the music, thus creating a shimmering effect. Beat flash effect. Finally, we use the flash effect synced to the beat of the music. Select the video on the timeline and add the HSL effect by going to Video Effects, Adjustments, Hue, Saturation, Lightness. In the Properties window, click on the three dots next to the Lightness Levels parameter. Go to the Templates and select the Edit the Beat template. In the pop-up window, set Silence to 100 and Amplitude to around 300. The Amplitude controls the maximum parameter deviation. Set Sensitivity to 100% and choose 0.1 seconds or less if you need more points for time between points. Then click on Create Points. You can preview the result without closing the Edit the Beat window and adjust the parameters if needed. Once done, click on OK. To smooth the effect, you can use either parameter change along a curve or Bezier curve in the key editor. You can also adjust the transparency of the effect by setting it to 50% in the transparency properties. That's all for today. In one of our upcoming videos, we will show you how to create text animations. Make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss it. Bye! Is it me? So you don't think this is me?